he is, gosh, I think he's 10 this year. He is owned by a really wonderful woman who rides in our barn. His name is Tiny, even though I think he's over 18 hands. But I've had the ride on him for a couple years now, and we just kind of play around in all the big equitation classes. He's super scopey and careful. He started with my trainer, Lindsay Archer, doing some of the hunter derbies when he was a younger horse. And so now we've moved him back into the equitation. He's really, really starting to come into his own. Everything walked a little bit more open than I think it ended up riding. Once you kind of got in there and got on ring pace from 1 to 2, it all sort of flowed. So I have a very large strided horse, so I did a lot of the leave outs. There was a line across the middle that we had walked in a 7 to a 1 to an 8, but I ended up just galloping up in 7. And you know, it invited, I think, more of a jumper style to stay within the time allowed and kind of get up those numbers. It was definitely different. I think, you know, there's a different feeling in the ring when you have the lights on. There's kind of like, it's almost like black walls around you, but it creates shadows that you're not necessarily thinking about when you're walking the course hours before. So I think for me anyway, I definitely had to be a little bit more definite and sure of where I was placing the horse and what I was asking him to do. I mean, he was phenomenal, but for sure needed to ride a little bit more in the second round. So I'm too old to be doing the big equitation now, but that's okay. It feels like I get to sort of do it all over again. I grew up riding on the East Coast, and I did the big equ when I was a junior, and then moved out here actually to go to law school, and moved into the jumpers a bit more. That's kind of more what my focus has been. So it's actually been great coming back to the equitation, having had a lot of that jumper experience. I've jumped up through the 130s and 140s a little bit, but to then come back to this and really focus on sort of the fundamentals and the discipline of it, I think has been wonderful. It's different. I think, you know, California has kind of when I was back east, you would do kind of a mix of the, not local shows, but they're the smaller shows that you just go on the weekends, kind of get reps and get points for the finals, and then also do Florida or, you know, Saugerties or whatever it was. Out here, I think we have a little bit of a different sort of feeling. Most of what I do is sort of thermal type horse shows. And then we have our finals and we go to indoors, you know, twice basically, which is a little different from the weather back east. But you know, it's a really good caliber of riders and trainers out here. And in that sense, it's exactly the same.